Hey guys, the dude from Denmark here, so welcome to episode 2 of Magic the Gathering Return to Ravnica, the new expansion that's about to come out. A lot of spoilers have been revealed today, including the new Jace Planeswalker, so let's check them out. In advance, I apologize for some of the card's bad quality. The new Jace in Ravnica is called Jace, Architect of Thought, which costs you 4 mana to cast. He starts off with 4 loyal counters. His first ability gives you 1 loyalty counter. Until your next turn, whenever a creature an opponent controls attacks, it gets -1/-0 on end of turn. His second ability costs you 2 loyal counters to do. Reveal the top 3 cards of a library. An opponent separates them into 2 piles. Put one of them into a hand and the other on the bottom of a library. His ultimate costs you 8 loyal counters to do. For each player, search that player's library for a non-land card and exile it. Then that player shuffles his or her library and you may cast this card without paying this mana costs. Ever since it got announced that Jace would appear in Ravnica again, people have been talking about which colors he would be, and I had really hoped for him to be red and blue. I really think another mono blue Jace is really boring, and this Jace also seems a bit boring. I'm just not into blue. I do like his ultimate though, I think it's really nice. But if you had been on the forum lately, you would have seen that a lot of fans were talking about which colors he could be. But of course, I think the whole plot of Magic: The Gathering would be better suited if he was mono blue. Chromatic Lantern is an artifact which costs you 3 mana to cast. Lands you control have add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool, and then itself can add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. This artifact seems really nice and I really like how cheap it is. Wayfaring Temple is an elemental which is green and white and costs you 3 mana to cast. Wayfaring Temple power and toughness are equal to a number of creatures you control. Whenever it deals combat damage to a player, you may populate. This creature seems to be a really fun creature, especially because it gets stronger for every time you populate. Roseway Scorpion is a black and green 2/2 scorpion creature which costs you 4 mana to cast. It got Death, Touch and is scavenged. You can pay 3 mana to exile this creature from your graveyard and give 2 1/1 counters to a target creature. Talisman Knight Charm is a green and white instant which costs you 2 mana to cast. You may choose one. Target creature gets +2/+2 against Trample on end of turn, or exile target creature with power 5 or greater. Or you may put a 2/2 white knight creature token with vigilance onto the battlefield. Another charm is Azurius Charm, which is a white and blue instant, which costs you 2 mana to cast. You may choose one. Creatures you control gain lifelink on end of turn, or you may draw a card or put target attacking or blocking creature on top of its owner's library. I really like these charms and I really like the idea of every guild have one. Turn is a black and red sorcery card which costs you 2 mana plus X mana. It deals X damage to target opponent and that player discard X cards. Civic Guildmage is a 2/2 blue and red human wizard creature which costs you 2 mana to cast. For 3 mana you can draw a card and then discard a card. For 4 mana you can copy target instant or sorcery spell you control and then you can choose new targets for this copy. Lyrith Skite Knight is a white and blue human knight creature which costs you 3 mana to cast and is the 3/1. It got flying. When it enters the battlefield, detain target non-land permanent and opponent control. Detain is a new mechanic in Ravnica, which makes the target creature unable to attack or block or use it activated its ability for the next turn. Detain seems like an okay mechanic, nothing really special I think. I do like that it's not only blue that got this mechanic, but also in this case white. I haven't seen any other cards yet with detain, so maybe other colors will also have it. The Triumvirate is a 4/5 white and blue creature which costs you 7 mana to cast. It got flying and whenever it attacks, you may detain up to 2 target creatures. The Immortals is a red sorcery card which costs you 2 mana to cast. It deals 4 damage to target creature you don't control. It got the overload mechanic, so in this case you can pay 5 mana and then exchange target with each. So in this case you can give 4 damage to each creature you don't control. I really like the overload mechanic, but it just seems like such a powerful mechanic that you have to pay a lot of mana to do this. Bosonic Dragon is a 4/4 blue and red creature, dragon creature, which costs you 5 mana to cast. It got flying and haste and you may cast sorcery spells as though they had flash. this is a really fun card and just make the whole mono blue and red cards really fun to play with. Bane Guardian is a green human druid creature which costs you 3 mana to cast. It's a 0/3 defender creature. You can tap this creature to add X mana in any combination of colors to a mana pool where X is the number of defenders you control. Corpsejack Menace is a 4/4 black and green fungus creature which costs you 4 mana to cast. If one or more 1/1 counters would be placed on a creature you control, twice that many 1/1 counters would be placed instead. Seriously, this creature is really crazy, especially with the mechanics scavenged and populates. It's going to be really nice to have this in decks like these. Dreadball is a black and red sorcery card which costs you 2 mana to cast. You may destroy target creature or planeswalker. Ice is a white instant card which costs you 4 mana to cast. Put a 1/1 white bird creature token with flying onto the battlefield, then populate. This is a really neat card, especially because you can either choose to get a new copy of this card or another copy of another token that lies on the battlefield. Creeper Vine is a 0/2 defender creature plant which costs you 2 mana to cast. When it enters the battlefield, you may search your library for a basic land card or a gate card, reveal it and put it onto your hand. Gutter Snipe is a red goblin shaman creature which costs you 3 mana to cast. It's a 2/2 and whenever you cast an instant or sorcery card, it deals 2 damage to each opponent. Carnival Hellsteed is a 5/4 black and red nightmare horse creature which costs you 6 mana to cast. It got first strike, haste and a new mechanic, Unleash. People have been talking a lot on the forums about this Unleash mechanic for Ravnica, whether it's really bad or it's good or what it is. The first card we saw were a bit boring, I think. This card is seems to be a bit better. It can be a 6/5 with the first strike and haste, which is really crazy, I think, but I have yet to see another creature with Unleash that's a bit more fun than these two we have seen before. Heroes Reunion is a green and white instant card which costs you 2 mana to cast. Target player gets 7 life. Orc Jailbreaker is a black orc rogue creature which costs you 4 mana to cast. It's a 4/4 defender and it can only attack if you control a gate. In Ravnica there are lands which are gates, which means that if you want to have this creature to could attack, you have to control this type of land. I'm not sure yet if there's other gates that are not only lands, but maybe there's also creatures that have some kind of gate element to it. There's a black red creature which costs you 2 mana to cast. Pack Rat's power and toughness are each equal to the number of rats you control. You can pay 3 mana to discard a card and then put a token onto the battlefield that's a copy of Pack Rat. This creature seems like a really fun creature, especially if you put populates together with it. The Salvage is a black and green instant card which costs you 2 mana to cast. Reveal the top 5 cards of your library. You may put a creature or land card from among them onto your hand and then put the rest in the graveyard. The cards I wanted to show today. I hope you liked this episode of Return to Ravnica. If you want, you can subscribe to me to follow more of my videos. In the upcoming weeks there will be more episodes for the new spoilers that's about to come out. So if you want, you can subscribe to me. And until next time, have fun guys.